Do you feel the pressures around you as you follow Jesus? Good morning, everyone. This is our reflection question for today. A few years ago, a riot took place in the House of Representatives in the state of Kansas. The elected representatives started their session with prayer, but one day the prayer caused an uproar. The prayer went like this: Heavenly Father, we come before you today to ask your forgiveness and seek your direction and guidance. We know your word says, "Woe to those who call evil good," but that's exactly what we've done. We have lost our spiritual equilibrium and we have inverted our values. We confess that we have ridiculed the absolute truth of your word and called it moral pluralism, and worshipped other gods and called it multiculturalism. We have endorsed perversion and called it an alternative lifestyle. We have exploited the poor and called it the lottery, and neglected the needy and called it self-preservation. We have killed our unborn and called it choice, and shot abortionists and called it justifiable. We have neglected to discipline our children and called it building self-esteem, and abused power and called it political savvy. We have coveted our neighbor's possessions and called it ambition, and polluted the airwaves with profanity and pornography and called it freedom of expression. We have ridiculed the time-honored values of our forefathers and called it enlightenment. Search us, O God, and know our hearts today. Try us and see if there be some wicked way in us. Cleanse us from every sin and set us free. Guide and bless these men and women who have been sent here by the people of Kansas and have been ordained by you to govern this great state. Grant them your wisdom to rule, and may their decisions direct us to the center of your will. I ask it in the name of your Son, the living Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Indeed, Jesus came not to bring peace, but the sword in today's gospel reading. How difficult and disturbing today's reading is, especially when a member of one's family is pitted against another. Be it the family of believers, or any group espousing a cause or in governance, but most especially from one's own blood family. In the first place, we know and call Jesus as the Prince of Peace. In John 14:27, during the Last Supper, Jesus said that he came to give peace to his disciples and that no one can ever take it away from them. And so his words today seem puzzling. We reflect on these. We know that he sees the future more than we can and knows that these conflicts will happen in spite of his teachings of love. It says more about us than him. He brings to us the sword, not a physical one, but a spiritual one, that cuts through the core of our sinfulness, influenced by Satan and his minions. When people hear of Jesus' message of truth, love, justice, and freedom, many will oppose these because they see his teachings as a real threat to their own selfish ends. That was why Jesus was often rejected, and we too can and are rejected often for espousing the truths Jesus taught. Father Dave Concepcion, Santa Maria Goretti's parish priest, narrates his journey towards priesthood. His father was an elder of a Protestant church. When Father Dave told him that he wanted to become a priest, for 4 years his father did not talk to him. On his deathbed, he and his father finally made peace. But all throughout his years in the seminary, Father Dave suffered emotionally, cried silently, pained by the rejection he felt from his father. But he soldiered on and followed Christ. On his father's deathbed, his father whispered to him how concerned he was that when he leaves this earth, who will take care of his son who only subsists on a meager allowance? Father Dave understood. Perhaps in those years when his father did not want to face him, even during his visits home, the Lord was slowly shaping his father's heart. Eventually, his father understood, and by God's grace, when Father Dave was ordained, his father was the proudest, grinning from ear to ear, and Father Dave felt relieved and grateful that finally God made things right because he chose to follow him completely. Christianity has divided families. When close families object to the vision of following Jesus that other family members choose, the latter can be hated and rejected and expelled. The Christian in them must respond, with the love that Jesus, the rejected himself, offered. When we trust God and allow him to govern our lives fully, we are justly rewarded in time, wrongs righted in this life, or perhaps not in this life, but surely in the life after. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, keep me focused on you and your teachings, despite the rejections I may face, as I hold on to your promise of peace and eternal bliss. This I pray in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic faith and couples for Christ.